seated. Because God's image indwells each of us, we are able to know and experience true love. And when we come together on a day like this, we have been invited to experience the greatest expression of love, which is worship. As we get to celebrate the love with which God loved us through Jesus, and we get to celebrate the love that He invites this man and this woman to celebrate in marriage. And in that celebration, we are thanking God. We are celebrating the gift of love, and we are celebrating two lives coming together as husband and wife. And so today, Dalton and Amy welcome you as they pledge their lives to each other, as they engage in a very special promise of their lives to each other, and as they thank God for bringing them together. What an incredible place, what a magnificent opportunity to engage in worship together and celebrating with Dalton and Amy today. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I.
Well, since we are here to worship and celebrate, let's begin with prayer. God, I thank you for this really special place, this really special occasion. Lord, I celebrate with Dalton and Amy that they know that you have orchestrated the events of their lives to bring them together on this very special day. Lord, thank you for inviting us to be here and to see what you are doing in them right in front of our very eyes. God, we thank you for sending Jesus. He showed us what love is all about by giving his life. And today, we get to watch as these two individuals give their lives to each other. May you bless this time of worship. May you already bless this couple as they promise their lives to each other. God, we worship you and we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Well, today we all get to be here and see this, but there are some that we are missing. So as we begin, we have a reading remembering the loved ones who have gone on before us. On this special day, we remember that loved ones are missing today, ones our hearts hold on to as we travel along life's way. Loved ones who made life so special for all those who gather here, ones who won't be forgotten but cherished from year to year. And now as we pause to remember, let us all fondly recall how dearly each of us loved them, and oh, how they loved us. Although we cannot see you, we know that you are near, and we want you to know your love is still our guide. Memories carried in our hearts, you will always be at our side. It's so sad that you will not be here on the day that Dalton and Amy say, I do. And so they say their vows today in loving memory of you. So at the end of this service, after we sign a couple documents, legally, you will be husband and wife. And not just in the state of Illinois and the United States of America, but also before God. But as you promise your lives to each other in this service, it's important to remember that words are pretty easy to say. So today you will be married, but tomorrow you will choose to be married. That tomorrow and the next and then the next, each of those days, every day, deciding that you will be husband and wife to each other. And so today we hear you say, I do. And tomorrow you get to decide that you will, in fact, do and keep that promise. When we look in Scripture, it is very clear that the two cornerstones of marriage are love and commitment. In love, it makes life so much more because you have joys to share with one another. When you have a burden that you're carrying, you have a partner to divide it with. And then you have more courage to reach out in ways that, man, you wouldn't have done that by yourself. But now you have someone who will do that with you. And so as we think about what Scripture says, We're first going to hear from 1 Corinthians 13 as the Apostle Paul describes love for all of us in every situation. And today we get to see it in a really beautiful way in your marriage. So Callie, if you would come.
May the sun rise and set in your bonded hearts, and the moon never find you too long apart. May you cherish each other's dreams as you own and turn stumbling blocks into stepping stones. May you brave life's mountains and miles together. May there be no storm your love cannot weather. May you be lovers and allies and friends. May your soul's conversations never end. May you capture on earth what's in heaven above. May your hearts know the rapture of uncommon love.
Amy, Dalton, you ready to do this?
Yeah.
I've not yet talked about the contents of chapter 6. Guys, it has been such a pleasure to get to know you a little bit more. As we've had time to talk about being a husband and a wife, and I've got to say, I see such a beautiful complementary relationship that you guys have for each other. There's one of you that's a little more planned, one of you that's a little more spontaneous. That's going to help. There is one of you that in thinking about life, you assume the best of people. And one of you that assumes the worst of people. There's also one of you who tends to save and the other one that tends to spend, but the saver likes to spend a lot at one time. And I just see so many ways that you guys in your personalities and the way that God has made you, you complement each other. But even more than complementing each other, I hear in both of you a commitment to each other. Because those things that complement, at times they annoy and they frustrate. But you have a beautiful gift that you both are trusting our Lord as you start this relationship. And this is more than just, hey, this is working out good. I think we fit well together. I think we could do this. Because you are walking into this out of a commitment to our Lord. Dalton, in taking Amy to be your lawful and wedded wife, before God and these witnesses present, you must promise to love her, to honor and cherish her, and leaving all others to cleave only to her, and be to her in all things the true and faithful husband so long as you both shall live. Do you so promise? Amy, in the same way, in taking Dalton to be your lawful and wedded husband, before God and these witnesses present, you must promise to love him, to honor and cherish him, and leaving all others to cleave only to him, and be to him in all things the true and faithful wife, so long as you both shall live. Do you so promise? as an expression of their vows to each other, their commitment to each other. Dalton and Amy have both written personalized vows, both of which the other has not yet heard. So Dalton, if you would take this and express your commitment to Amy.
Right.
Yes.
Okay. So the first time I saw you, I felt something I had never felt before. I knew in my heart that you were the one for me to marry. To spend my life in making memories and adventures, travels, future plans, and chapter 6 kind of nights. So here we are, my Amy, standing here today in front of our family and friends. In a few moments, I'll have the privilege to call you my wife. On our first day, I remember the outfit you wore and how bad I bummed asking for your phone number. I think you did give it to me out of pity, but it worked out because here we are today. We talked for so long on the first date, we shut the whole place down. I think they tried to kick us out. And to this day, we don't even need a radio in the car because we talked so much. But I cherish our conversation so much. Big or small, I truly do love them all. I hated saying goodbye to you that night. I didn't want it to end. And I hated letting you go, but I did love watching you walk away. When I look at you, I don't just see a beautiful woman. I see my best friend. The woman is willing to climb the highest mountain with me, and I know you will always be by my side. I promise the adventures won't stop. My need for your constant eye-rolling and sweet laugh that I can't get enough of. It's my mission every day to make you laugh until you cry. Or pee. Whatever else. Amy, I vow to you, my heart will be your home. My love for you will be unwavering, unshakable, and unbreakable. I vow to be your rock. I'll protect you, defend you, provide for you. You pick the place, I'll be there. You find something you need, I'll find a way to make it happen. If you need me there, I'll always be there. Today you stand before me as my beautiful princess. But from this day on, I'll make you my queen. I love you forever and always.
Amy, if you will share your vows with Dalton as well, please.
When I was little, I was taught to believe in fairy tales. After all, what little girl doesn't dream of being a princess and marrying her Prince Charming? As I grew up, I quickly learned finding my prince was going to be a little harder than I originally thought. There were times when I thought you were never going to show up. But Mom always told me, good things come to those who wait. And after waiting patiently for many years, my once upon a time started to unfold. In cold winter night at a comedy show here in Southern Illinois when I met you, Thomas Dalton Spiller. From the first time we met, I knew you were different. I mean, no one has ever accidentally called me Laura when asking me on a date. And I never usually end up giving guys second chances. So let's just say you hit the lottery that night. Or maybe I couldn't turn down that charming smile, infectious personality, and of course, those guns of steel. Dalton, you're my best friend. I can't imagine doing life without you by my side. You're brutally honest, even if it hurts. You hold me accountable no matter what. You calm me down when I'm stressing out. You encourage me to always chase my dreams, no matter how big or how small. You love me on my best days and my worst days. You love me with or without makeup. You love my imperfections and accept me for who I am. You know how to make me laugh uncontrollably. You bring out my adventurous side and challenge me to try new things. And most importantly, you support my shoe collection. Dalton, I promise to always encourage you, inspire you, and respect you. I promise to love you when times are good, like in those Hallmark movies I make you watch, and when times are hard. No matter how difficult times get, I promise to never give up on you or us. I will forever be there to laugh with you, to lift you up when you are down, and to love you unconditionally through all of our crazy adventures. I promise to love you not only today, but always and forever.
One of the ways that Dalton and Amy will be expressing their commitment to each other, to those who didn't get to be here today, will be through the exchanging of rings. These beautiful rings will represent the unending commitment that you are expressing to each other. You could have held out. I mean, you had the power in your hands there for a second. All right, Dalton, please go first. If you will take this ring, place it on Amy's left hand, and repeat after me. This ring I give you. In token and pledge.
In token and pledge.
Of our constant faith.
Our constant faith.
And abiding love.
Abiding love.
With this ring.
This ring.
I commit my life to you.
I commit my life to you.
In the name of the Father. And of the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit,
and the Holy Spirit. Amy, if you will take this ring, place it on Dalton's left hand, and also repeat after me. This ring I give you.
This ring I give you.
In token and pledge.
In token and pledge.
Of our constant faith.
In our constant faith.
And abiding love.
And abiding love.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I commit my life to you. In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Father, I ask your blessing upon this couple. This incredible miracle that you are doing right before our very eyes as they have exchanged these beautiful symbols that they are committed to each other. God, may you bless this couple. May they sense your anointing. May they sense the courage and the boldness that comes from you to express their love unconditionally, without reservation, without doubt, without any sort of hesitation. God, may you bless this couple. May you do what only you can do in making two lives one flesh. God, may you protect their home. May you protect their future and guide them as they take every step now together as husband and wife. To you be the glory. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Sometimes we refer to getting married as time knot. Scripturally, it refers to a beautiful coming together in partnership as the weaving of a rope. Ecclesiastes 4 says this, two are better than one because they have a good return for their work. If one falls down, his friend can help him up, but pity the man who falls and has no one to help him up. Also, two lie down together, they will keep warm, but how can one keep warm alone? Though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. A cord of three strands is not easily broken. As a symbol of their lives coming together, Dalton and Amy will be weaving together a rope symbolizing their lives coming together with God at the center.
Fireplace, you know the shine.
Well, as we said earlier, as we attend a wedding ceremony, we're actually participating in worship as we thank the one who created the love in which is being expressed by Dalton and Amy today. As they become husband and wife, they now have a special opportunity to worship together. And symbolizing that fact, Dalton and Amy will be taking communion together as part of our worship today. That you are husband and wife.